Today, I would like to introduce you to the official WhatsApp Business API. WhatsApp is currently one of the most popular messaging apps in the world, and if you have been using WhatsApp or WhatsApp Business and looking to scale your business, this video is for you. Some common issues with the WhatsApp Business native app is that it has to be installed on one smartphone and up to four companion devices can be linked to the same account. But if the original smartphone that has WhatsApp installed isn't active for 14 days, all linked devices will be logged off automatically. Besides, you can only select up to 256 contacts in a broadcast list to send bulk messages. All the contacts must have saved your number in their address book to receive your messages. Not to mention that the only way to personalize a message is by repetitively copy and pasting the same text in different chat rooms and changing the personal details manually. WhatsApp is committed to protecting users from suspicious messages, so there is always a risk of account suspension when your users report the broadcast messages as spam. Also, the native app comes with very simple messaging statistics. The lack of a business dashboard that identifies trends in new inquiries, response time, bounce rate, etc., makes it very difficult to measure results of your WhatsApp marketing campaigns or customer service success. What's the solution? The official WhatsApp Business API. It is a developer tool that empowers businesses by sending automated replies, interactive messages, and personalized bulk messages. It doesn't have a real interface, but you can work with a service provider and unlock these benefits. Apply for WhatsApp Green Tick Verification, which provides customers with a confidence boost or reassurance when they first get into contact with your business. Set up a WhatsApp Business profile that always displays your company name, even if the receiver has not saved your contact. Unlimited multiple simultaneous logins to provide customer support as a team, while managers can assign and monitor conversations to ensure consistency and quality. Send personalized messages to thousands of contacts with a few clicks to broadcast updates, transactional messages, and promotions. Integrate WhatsApp communication with your CRM software to capture personal details of potential customers. Run drip and retargeting campaigns by delivering automated messages triggered by specific events and behaviors. Build chatbots to qualify and convert conversations, as well as measure various conversion metrics such as lead inquiries and click-through rate. Integrate with your e-commerce store or customize a product catalog to share shopping cart details and one-click checkout links through WhatsApp. Now, let's move on to the message pricing. Customer relationships are dependent on way beyond just a single message. So WhatsApp charges are based on per 24-hour conversation session, regardless of the number of messages exchanged by the business and the user in the session. Now, there are two types of conversations. User-initiated, a conversation that initiates in response to a user message, and business-initiated, a conversation initiated by a business to users who haven't contacted them in the last 24 hours. Now, the price rate differs from region to region. For example, in the UK, the price per user-initiated conversation and business-initiated conversation is $0.0388 and $0.0647, respectively, while in Hong Kong and Singapore, the cost for user-initiated conversation is $0.0224 USD and $0.0745 USD for a business-initiated conversation. And for Malaysia, on the other hand, charges of $0.0220 and $0.0732. But hey, before you get caught up with the calculations, there's a little surprise here. For every WhatsApp Business account, WABA, the first 1,000 conversations every month are free. And if people message you directly from an ad that clicks to WhatsApp or a Facebook page call to action button, the conversion is also free of charge. Since we've covered the flexible pricing charged by WhatsApp, it's time to talk about the fixed API service provider cost. We strongly recommend for you to choose a business solution provider verified by WhatsApp's mother company, Meta. They provide authorized services that stop your businesses from being banned due to spam message reports. When you reach out to a new customer through the official WhatsApp Business API, you will need to create a message template and gain pre-approval from WhatsApp before sending. It can be a customer care message or an appointment reminder, payment or shipping updates, alerts, and many more. You can include multimedia files like photos and videos and insert variable parameters like name or birthday to personalize the message. You can also set up three quick reply buttons, a list message, or a call to action button that links to your website. It usually takes 3 hours to 1 day for template approval. Keep in mind that you'll need to follow WhatsApp requirements, including making sure that your variable parameters, translations, and links in the messages are correct, and attach a sample while submitting your template. Some of the common mistakes are the message has spelling or grammar mistakes that makes it look like a spam or a hoax. There is no clear definition for specific variable parameters, like the type of media you plan to send in a media message. You are not using double curly brackets to insert variable parameters. The link contains a shortened URL, or the URL domain does not actually belong to your business. Moving forward, let's take a closer look at how a 24-hour customer service window works. For user-initiated conversations, the 24-hour countdown will only start when you reply to the user, not when the user first reaches out to you. For business-initiated conversations, the 24-hour countdown starts when you send out a template message. For example, if you reach out at 3 p.m. on the 5th of July and the customer does not reply by 2:59 p.m. on the 6th of July, the conversation will end there and be counted as one business-initiated conversation. If your customer replies at 4 p.m. on the 6th of July, you can reply to them and continue to chat as it opens another 24-hour session window. That would be counted as a user-initiated conversation, and no template message is required since user replies imply that they give the business permission to send messages to them. However, any messages sent to the customer more than 24 hours since they last contacted you should be in pre-approved templates and will be defined as business-initiated conversations. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions about what we have covered in this video, you can head over to our app and select the Help Center button on the bottom right corner. Click the Submit a Ticket button, then type in your inquiry and submit your request. We'll get back to you within 3 business days.